Yeah, he came in the vehicle with me, and I had the radio on, and I spoke to somebody in Argentina, and he couldn't believe that I was in my van talking to somebody in Argentina. And he loves listening to radio and shortwave, but he'd never got anything to really decent. And he said, I'm going to get me a shortwave receiver. Well, now, he's got himself a transmitter, and he's transmitting all the time. He's got the bug, and he just says to me, oh, what a great hobby. Why didn't I get into this before, you know? And he's sort of 50 years old now. You know, he's getting on a bit. But he loves it, and it's a great hobby, you know. As long as you don't kick the backside out of it, you know. Because I think, you know, people that I've known over the years have come on and really kicked the hell out of it. Been out every night, every morning, you know. And all of a sudden, I've worked the world, and I'll get rid of it now. You know, I've never done that. Never. I go on occasionally, you know. I go on most weeks, but I don't kick the backside out of it, Gary, over.
Yeah, Roger Dick, all copied. Yeah, I'm pretty much the same. I wouldn't say I'm on it every day. I invariably turn the radio on whilst I'm doing stuff and just listening to 555 or stateside down on 38. But I get an awful lot of interference at the home QTH, so that puts a bit of a downer on it, to be fair. I get a floor noise of about S8, S9, and it does take the pleasure out of the hobby, to be fair. But whilst you're out like this, static mobile, it is nice. It's a great hobby, as you say, to have a flit around. And I'm the same. Whilst it's nice to make some long-distance contacts, it's not the be-all and end-all. I'd much rather know that my radio is working fine, get a couple of half-decent local contacts in, chew the fat for 10 or 15, Roger.
Yeah, Roger, definitely, yeah. Yeah, a great hobby. I must say, this Stalker 9, you know, although I've got a TS-50, you know, I'm not dissing the TS-50, but I've worked the world over and over and over on this Stalker 9. You know, I've worked Australia with 10 watts for the K40 last year. Amazing, you know. So I don't suppose I'll ever get a better radio than this. You know, no matter how much I pay. You know, I actually swapped it for an antenna called a BT101 Tiger. It's like a dipole with a basket on the bottom, like a Sigi 4 basket. It was useless, and this guy I knew, he was actually a rig repairer. He was repairing this radio. I said, I need an SSB rig, you know, just as a spare. And he said, oh, he said, I've only got this bloody Stalker 9, you know. And I said, oh, that'll do, I said. You know, I said, what does it do? And he said, oh, it just does two blocks at the minute. But he put the alphas in and the zeros on a switch, both on switches. And he said, what have you got? What have you got to swap for it? And he said, I need an antenna. So I said, oh, I've got a BT-101. I said, I wouldn't vouch for it. I was quite honest with him. But I said, you know, the SWAR's one-to-one on the damn thing. So he said, that's all I need. That's all I need. I'll have that. And it was really well made, this antenna. It really looked the part with sort of superb grade aluminium. But it was crap. It was crap. So I swapped the antenna for this radio, and it's been the best radio I could ever have. You know, as I said, it's worked the world over and over, and my TS-50 probably won't get the chance to do that, because I very rarely take it in the mobile, Gary, over.
Yeah, Roger Dick, all copied. Yeah, it sounds like the Stalker's definitely a keeper. I've never had one myself, but I've often seen them on the forums and on the auction sites, and I've always been tempted. But a good old school radio, they look old school as well, don't they? You know, they are old school, but they actually look it as well. But I've never had one. And as far as the K40 goes, I mean, how long have they been around? They've never changed. You know, they're tried and tested. You know, they do the business. And if I recall, the only reason I sold mine was to fund something else. But the one I've got at the moment, it seems that I had the 5000, the Serio 5000 at one time. But there's little difference in them, to be fair, on paper, other than the power handling. When it comes to doing the business, they're both identical, so I'm stuck with the 4000 at the moment, and I'm happy with it. With your permission, Dick, I've recorded a little bit of footage on me phone, so I may well upload that at some stage when I get back. With your permission, you'll be able to listen to what your radio sounds like, Dick.
Yeah, what will that be on?
It's likely to be on YouTube, Roger.
Yeah, Roger. Yeah, great. I'll look for that. I wonder, what have I got to look for?
Well, if you type in Stalker 9, what was your call sign again, Dick?
Actually, I'm a Jolly Roger number as well. I've got a Jolly Roger number that I usually use. I'm Jolly Roger 1564, but I am a Fox Baker 600, over.
Roger, Fox Baker 600. If you type Fox...